Hey guys, it's Smarty, and today I will be showing you how to get yourself the cheapest LED controller with HomeKit. We will be using a device called MagicHome LED controller, which by default has its own firmware, and to use it you have to download their MagicHome app and connect the device to their cloud. Therefore, communication happens through their Chinese cloud, and if you have no internet or they get hacked, you won't be able to use your LED strip. Thankfully, it's using the ESP8266 chip, so we have plenty of firmwares to choose from. I will be using HomeKit Accessory Architect to add HomeKit support, as this is what I have set up at home, and it is one of the few protocols that works not only securely to the cloud, but also locally when I'm home, so it's not dependent on my internet connection. To power the controller and the LEDs, you need a 12-volt power supply, similar to this one. Or you can build something like this using separate components. But for now, put the power unit on the side and don't connect it yet. To flash the device, open its enclosure with something thin. The zero pins are usually on the back of the controller. You can put a bit of solder on them so that you can more easily attach wires for flashing. And as you are about to see, this is just what I'm going to do. After some soldering, we should have the wires attached and we can now connect them to the serial adapter. I will be using a breadboard for easier wiring, but you can do as you please as soon as you have stable connections. As with the other controllers, we'll connect TX to RX, RX to TX, ground to ground, and V33 to 3.3 volts from your adapter. Pin named 100 or IO0 is GPIO0, so connecting it to ground for a few seconds on boot is how we put the device in flash mode. This next part I have covered in another video, so please head over there to watch it first and then continue with the next steps. After a successful flashing, disconnect your serial adapter from your computer and connect the MagicHome controller to DC power. This is required as the power from the adapter might be insufficient for a proper boot. You can find the example JSON strings in the link in the video description. In my case, I'm using an RGB controller, but yours might be a RGBW or a RGB, but with a different pin order. More on that later in the video. After you set up the device, add it to the home app and test it out. I say test it because the provided JSON strings might not work for your controller, as there are many modifications of the board with switched color GPIO pins. Because of that, I have added a few MagicHome JSON strings in the video blog post, so make sure you try them out before proceeding with debugging. If that doesn't work, as mine, it's not hard to get them right. Set the color to red, and if it doesn't light in red, then try changing the red GPIO value. In this case, the green value is incorrect, so we have to change it. Then, turn on and off the device 8 times to put it in setup mode. After that, open the browser and head to the device's hostname.lan or .local. You can try both. It depends on your network configuration. If it doesn't load but your device still works in HomeKit, try getting it in setup mode again by turning it off and on 8 times. If your device is unreachable in HomeKit and in the browser, then try to reach it via its IP, which you can find in your router settings or with an app like Fink via your smartphone. When you open the setup page, you can modify the JSON configuration string and correct the colors. As I said, in my case, I need to correct the green value. And the variables for RGB are R, G, and V respectively. The GPIO pins you can try are 4, 5, 12, 13, 14, and 15. If you still don't get proper red, green, and blue, do the same for green and blue, and then you should be getting the color you set it to. After you make sure everything is working properly and the setup is finished, you can disconnect the wires from the device. Make sure not to pull them, as you might not be able to connect again for flashing in the future. Simply use a soldering gun to disconnect them with ease. When that's done, we can put the case back on. Now that we have our brand new HomeKit LED controller, it is time to mount it and its LEDs. I have the LED strip going around my bed, with the controller and its power supply hidden behind it. And now, check out the final result. But before that, please like the video if you found it helpful, comment down below with suggestions for future videos, and subscribe for more smart stuff. Enjoy the video!